Today I start topic number 2, internal wiring and industrial wiring. So it is start with definition phase. Definition I have written on the board, you can note down it. This is clearly visible to you. Internal wiring is defined as it is the wiring carried out to provide supply to light and fans and other domestic appliances at their rated voltage and current. Okay, this is the definition of internal wiring. This particular topic consists of two portion, one is internal wiring and another is industrial wiring. So in this particular case, internal wiring, there are two types of classification of this wiring, that is its types, that is in system. Types of internal wiring classified as system of wiring, and second is methods of wiring. In system of wiring, there is a casing KP. It is of wooden, or it is called wooden casing KP. Second is wooden baton wiring. Then third is cleat wiring. Fourth is PVC conduit wiring. And fifth is metallic conduit wiring. These are the five type of systems of wiring which are in use. Now these two system, wooden casing caping and baton, they are not in use nowadays. Problem is that wood is not available for manufacturing of casing caping and baton, and secondly, whatever type of manpower required to this laying of this wiring, it is not available, that is skill is not available, we can say. So commonly the wiring which is used nowadays, they are mostly PVC conduit wiring and metal conduit wiring. Apart from this cleat wiring is used for temporary application. Whenever there is a outdoor type of application of supply is required for pandals and any type of function in trade fairs or whatever type of arrangement to be done for external type application, then we use cleat wiring. There are porcelain cleat, consist of porcelain, and they are having grooves for running the wire like this, and they are closed from both the side with the help of screw or nut bolts, and wire will run from these slots, say R phase, Y phase, B phase and neutral. So this is a cleat. This is a porcelain cleat looking like this, and this can be used. Wire can be drawn from this, and when we have the application part, then for whatever distance you can provide it, it can be done like this, RYB and neutral, and these cleats are supported like this. Cleats is supported like this, and you can run the wiring for any span or any distance. So this is the cleat wiring for temporary application. Temporary application. The wiring, PVC conduit and metallic conduit, they are now commonly used for domestic purpose. So in domestic application we use only these two wiring, last one, PVC conduit and metallic conduit. So this PVC conduit, it is a pipe of PVC available in different diameters, and with the help of saddles we can put these saddles to support the pipe on the wall. To support the pipe on the wall, so these saddles are support the wall, and number of wires they required for neutral phase, phase neutral and earth wire. Earth wire normally run from outside. It is like this. This is the earth wire. Earth wire, it is of 14 gauge, and pipes available in different dia, 12.5 mm, 25 mm and 37.5 mm. These are the pipes available in the field for installing conduit wiring. Number of wire, they can be run from 1 to 6. 1 to 6 wire can be carried according to the diameter. In the small diameter pipe, three wire can be run. In this you can take 4 wire or 5 wire, and in this up to 6 wire. So these are the number of wires can be run in this particular diameter. Similarly, if it is a PVC conduit, then same diameter power, this conduit of metal is available, that is of mild steel or MS. So that is called metallic conduit. Difference is that this is PVC, and another which is used for power wiring, it is a metal conduit. So for metal conduit, same dimensions are available, and they are called HG, that is heavy gauge. Heavy gauge metal conduit, HG means heavy gauge metal conduit. These are available for running this wiring. So these are the system of wiring we can use in this particular internal wiring process. Now, secondly, there is a methods of wiring. So methods of wiring are different. There are three methods. Methods of wiring. There are three methods. We can have, one is MDB method, MDB method, it is called man distribution board method. Second is tree method, and third is loop-in method. Okay. These are the three methods of wiring we are used. Normally this wiring method is preferred because of its certain advantage. This is not preferred, and this is preferred whenever we want to expand the existing wiring. Loop-in method can be used with MDB and tree method. But tree method have a certain disadvantage that it have a one single control for different circuits. If there is any fault occur in any circuit, then whole system will become dark or it will be faulted. In MDB system, for every circuit there is a different controls are provided by MCB or cutouts. So we can use, mostly we use the MDB system. Looping system it is used in for extension work. Suppose existing wiring is there and if you want some additional points in some room or some place inside, then you loop it from the existing wiring, that is called looping system. Now here I will draw the diagram of all the three and explain how they work. So first is MDB system. It is used both in single phase and three phase. There is a distribution board DB. It is provided with, suppose for single phase it is 230 volt 5 ampere and three way. If you can run three circuit then it will be three way. So how we run three circuit in this? You just go to connect MCB or cutouts and here you have the neutral link. Then we can run three circuit from this. This is one circuit, this is second circuit and this is third circuit. So circuit number one, circuit number two and circuit number three. What is the advantage? That whatever 230 volt is there on this particular distribution board, then you can get full voltage at the every circuit. Full voltage you can get on every circuit. If there is a fault in any one circuit, suppose circuit number 2 have a fault, so only that fuse will be blown, other two circuit will remain sustained, means supply is available on other two circuit if there is a fault in one circuit. Similarly, this DB can be designed for three phase system in which you have three bus bar of R by B and one neutral link. This can be concealed or it can be managed in a particular RYB. You can put again MCB for each, similar to the single phase. It is a three phase wiring which can be done for three circuits. If you require three phase supply to given to some appliance which is operating on three phase, so this is R phase, Y phase, B phase, okay, and this is the neutral link. This whole thing, this whole components are enclosed in a distribution board, or it is a metallic structure of box type which can be installed on wall. And now here you can take one circuit for R phase, Y phase and B phase. This is the one circuit, and if you require neutral also, then neutral can be given. So R, Y, B and neutral, this is one circuit, circuit number one. Similarly, you can go for circuit number two, circuit number three, depending upon the requirement. The rating of this DB is available 3-way, 4-way, 6-way. Current rating is, say, we can say this particular 3-way 400 volt distribution board, 3-way 440 volt, and this ampere rating is normally 32 amperes. If you go higher loads in industry, then this will be 63 ampere or 100 ampere. But in domestic purpose, maximum we can go for 32 amperes if the distribution of electricity in different rooms on different loads or power appliances. So this is the first way, distribution board method, MDB method. This is having a single advantage. One is that fault occur in any one circuit, then only that circuit will trip, other circuit will function as it is. And second thing is that because every neutral and phase for every circuit, it is taped from the main distribution board. So voltage up to the last circuit, you will get the same voltage. There is a no difference of voltage. Only small voltage may drop due to line resistance. Otherwise, you can get sufficient voltage or rated voltage at the end of the circuit. Now, second method is tree method. In tree method, the arrangement is slightly different. There is a distribution board. This is a single circuit in which this is neutral and this is phase. So circuit will originate from here, and there are junction boxes are provided for taping of different circuits. Say originally this is one circuit, then you can go for second circuit, then you can go for third circuit like this. This is it, circuit number 1, circuit number 2, circuit number 3. Similarly, if you want to extend it, then again put junction box on neutral and phase, and you can run circuit number 4. Like this, you can, this is a, just like the branch of tree, the expansion is there. What is disadvantage? Disadvantage is that if there is a fault occur in any one circuit, say for example in this circuit fault will occur, whole supply will off because control is only one. So whole supply is off, all the circuit off. So there is a darkness in the building. So this particular method normally not prefer, but there is a one advantage of this method, that material required is less because we are taping from junction box. So less pipe and less wire is required. But what is the longest disadvantage? It is that when fault occur in one circuit, all three circuit or four circuit will off. Secondly, it is taped from different point. So at the last circuit, the voltage available, it is not sufficient. So that will cause the problem. So we are not use this system nowadays, but some people who are not technically qualified, ITI holders or other people, they are doing work in field without any experience or design aspect. They are using this type of wiring by convincing the customer that less cost. So people may go for less cost, so they prefer. But disadvantages are there. So this is the two method, MDB method and tree method. And third method is loop-in method. In loop-in method, what is happen? Suppose there is a tube light, it is already installed in the system, in which neutral and phase, it is coming from the main distribution board and it is controlled from a switchboard like this. Now suppose I require to install a socket point here in the existing system. So I will not bring supply and neutral from the main bus or main distribution board, but I can get it from phase tape from the nearest point available and neutral that is available from this point. So this is the looping. We have just looped this particular point by our existing system. This is the looping method. So in this way you can take number of points. The original system is here and this is looping that is done by loop of looping method. This is done by looping phase and neutral both from a particular nearest point available where neutral and phase are available. From that you can loop this. So these are the three methods. Normally for estimating costing in our subject, whatever estimate we will prepare, they will be only using MDV method because this is the most popular method and having the advantages which I have told you. And second thing is that installation is easy. Material used, this will be PVC conduit or metallic conduit. Metallic conduit normally used for power wiring and PVC conduit normally used for PVC wiring. This light and fail. Now neutral size in this internal wiring, it is 1 square mm. Phase required, it is 1.5 square mm. And for power wiring, we require 2.5 square mm. This is the size of copper wire. Normally copper wire is preferred because aluminum wire is having higher resistivity, one thing, and second thing, it's mechanical strength is poor. So in long term, it may be wiring may be break. So this is the size of wire, copper wire. This is for neutral. This is for phase of light and fail, and this is for phase of power wire. So these are the size of wire available. The other accessories, when we actually take the problem for preparing the estimate, then I will discuss other materials, whatever apart from this. So in lengthwise calculation, we have four items. One is PVC pipe that you have to calculate. PVC pipe. Second, conductor of aluminium or copper. And third is earth wire. Earth wire is of 14 gauge, normally used continuously run, and then earth wire conductor, PVC pipe, and neutral wire. These are the four calculations we have to carry out according to design available. PVC pipe requirement, as per requirement, as per the requirement we select the diameter. Conductor also selected as per the specification. Earth wire, it is 14 gauge continuously run along the pipe in a helical manner. And neutral wire run along with phase. They are insulated. Conductor and earth wire, conductor and neutral, they are insulated. PVC pipe is naturally outside. Earth wire, it is run on the PVC pipe to earth the leakage current whenever there is some leakage in the wiring. Now, this is the complete about the basic concept of system of wiring and methods of wiring. So, this article finish here. This is the topic number one, first article in which we discussed type and methods of wiring and how it can be done. I have also given the diagrams of every one. Now, you take it according.